exactly what we've got here in Eugene.
5 years ago, he came to the Olympic trials as a high schooler and started to knock off pros who were much more experienced. Now he finds himself with a very talented high schooler in Knighton trying to keep him off of the team. Three people will make the team. He is fourth fastest as we start here tonight.
And that stiff competition comes in the form of 17-year-old Arian Knighton.
Before these championships started, I thought he had an outside shot of finishing top three. After watching him break Usain Bolt's junior record running 1988, he is now the favorite. He turned 17 in January. He'd be the youngest man to make the U.S. track and field team since Jim Ryan qualified in 1964, the first high schooler since 1972.
And here's Benarek. He's been very steady and consistent through the rounds. He won his semifinal. And I think three people will not beat him tonight.
On the outside of Kenny Benarek is Isaiah Young. Terrence Laird is in nine. On the inside, very inside, is Fred Curley in two. Kyrie King, Andrew Hudson. That's your full field. Noah Lyles is in five.
When you come to the Olympic trials, you almost discard the paper. You trust what your eyes are telling you. And so far through the rounds, our eyes are telling us, Sonia, that Knighton has been looking better than anybody else. But this is the guy with the 19.5 PR. He has to summon a season's best to make this team.
The high schooler, the 17-year-old who's now gone pro, is fourth from the left.
And it's Benarek who will lead off of the turn. The high schooler has some work to do, but Noah Lyles is in a good position.
Here comes Noah Lyles, Kenny Benarek. How about Arian Knighton? That looks like the three going to Tokyo.
That is a huge win for Noah Lyles, who has not looked to be in this kind of shape throughout the rounds. But he was able to pull on his experience. He ran really well around the turn, Otto, which is not usually his strength. And I think Arian Knighton gave him too much and had too much work to do in the home stretch.
So Knighton becomes the first high schooler to make a U.S. Olympic team at 200 meters since 1972. He didn't run as well a turn as he did in the semifinals, but Lyles got the season's best that I talked about. That's also the fastest time in the world. And man, did he need it. So Benarek is on the team, Knighton's on the team, but the world champion, who has only lost one 200-meter race in his professional career, finds a way to get it done.
He's been saying, I'm okay. He's been asked questions about Knighton. He said, I've got it sorted. It's all going to plan. And I guess when it counted, it did.
Yeah, coming off the turn, Benarek had the lead. But when Noah Lyles is this close to the leaders, usually it's no problem. He worked for it. But he did a great job. Fastest time in the world. And he keeps his streak alive.
So how about this for Arian Knighton, who finished third behind Noah Lyles and Kenny Benarek. After turning 17 in January, Arian Knighton becomes the youngest man to make a U.S. Olympic track and field team since Jim Ryan qualified for the 1964 Tokyo team. You mentioned that before, Sonia. That is incredible. Here's Lewis.
All righty, and Noah, first to you. How did you summon the best race of the season that you needed in this Olympic Trials final?
To be honest, I relaxed. I stopped stressing. I let my body do what it does. You know, I was asking for a lot in the prelims. I was just thinking more and more and more. And then back there, after the break, you know, we came back and I just thought, you know, just flow. Flow, flow, let it come, let it come. I'm tired of stressing, I'm tired of fighting.
Yeah.
Let everything come.
My colleagues were commenting on how well you ran the turn. Was that part of the key to this win tonight?
Yeah, I've been practicing a lot on that turn, on that first 80, that first 120, and it's really come into handy. You know, now I feel that even though I'm 3 months behind training, I'm ready to go out there and I'm ready to come after everything.
3 months behind, that's amazing. Kenny, to you, we've had the pandemic, the weight, the trials delayed, and then even another delay today. So as you stood behind the blocks, what were you thinking about in terms of this opportunity?
Just stay focused and run my race. I had to make sure to get off with a good turn and then try to just maintain that. That's what I did. I hope to do a little bit better, but, you know, the result's the result, and, you know, I'm happy that I'm able to represent USA.
And what will that mean to you? What do you imagine about going to Tokyo for the Olympics?
Oh, it's a dream come true. You know, when I was younger, I always thought about, you know, being an Olympian, wanted to be an Olympian. And, you know, now I'm here, so, you know, I fulfilled my dream, and I got a lot of work to do.
You are there. Congratulations. And Arian, we want to say thank you for not running out of the stadium like you did after the semifinal. You stayed for the interview. He did a good job there, right, guys?
He did a great job.
You're only 17 on the biggest stage you've ever been on. How did you keep your composure and show your talent to get yourself on this Olympic team?
I just stayed focused on what I had to do. I feel like I went out here and ran the race to my own capability. But words can't explain how I feel right now.
As you get to the other side of the world, what more do you need to learn about racing, about the rounds, about just the bigger stage and more pressure that'll be expected on you?
Really just staying focused. Like the whole week, come up here, have your mindset prepared, and my ability to do the talking.
Excellent. All right, you can join your teammates for a victory lap. Congratulations. Lee?
So two quick footnotes to this race. This young man on your screen, Knighton, lowers Usain Bolt's